strange. Well, anyway, soon after, there was a big article in the town paper saying Mr. Wonka was going to sell a lot of chocolate candy and was running a contest.
Yes, sir, that's right, a contest. Secretly wrapped 5 golden tickets under 5 ordinary candy bars. The candy bars were said to be found in any town, and on any street, in any shop, upon the counter in the country, in the world, upon the counter where Wonka came.
Tour Mr. Wonka's factory and take home enough chocolate for the rest of their lives. Now that, my friend, is where our story begins. 4 of the tickets have already been found. Oh yeah, would you like to meet the 4 lucky people?
Alright, now listen and watch carefully.
Joe
and Grandma Josephine.
makes me feel like I'm just going to walk chocolate. Every day as I go to school, that smell of the wonder of chocolate makes me so drunk. I have to fall asleep and go to the bathroom on this bed. But I should realize dreams don't come true. Just imagine me imagining I can get the potential. What is it? It's pure imagination.
Well, my boy, it may be pure imagination, but I can tell that what you imagine sometimes comes true.
Gee, you're getting so rapid. I'm going to.
Yeah. Galloping back for a second helping. When I went out there, I found little Oompa Loompas living in a treehouse.
is alive, and I do promise you that your darling boy is perfectly safe.
If he's safe, where does he lead me to a distance?
Go over to one of the ones and tell them to take you to the fudge room. And when you get there, start poking around inside the big chocolate mixing barrel with a long stick. When you find him, don't leave him in there too long, or he's liable to get poured out into the fudge boiler. And that really could be a disaster.
What did you say?
I'm sorry. This is Blue. See you later.
Just this blue, a great big greeting named Kung Fu.
mouth and suck it and suck it and suck it, and it'll never get any smaller.
It's like gum.
It's not like gum. Gum is for chewing. And if you try to chew one of these gobstoppers, you break your teeth off. This machine over here is for making hair toffee. So when I'm done, there'll be no more reasons for little boys and girls to go around and call pets.
But Mr. Wonka, none of the little boys and girls go around the house.
Don't argue with your child. And this machine over here is I'm most proud of. It's for me a most sensational gum. In fact, it's a chewing gum. When she comes out of the de-juicing machine, she'll be
a sticky end.
Did any of you know a person named Miss Bigelow?
This dreadful woman saw Nora all chewing, chewing all day long. And when she couldn't find her gun, she chewed up the linoleum.
Or anything that happened near.
Her boots.
The postman's ear.
Or other people's underclothes.
And when she chewed her boyfriend's nose.
For years and years she chewed away, consuming 50 packs a day.
Until one summer's eve, alas,
a hard business came to pass.
Miss Bigelow went late to bed.
For half an hour she lay in red.
At last she put her gum away on a special little tray. And she settled back to go to sleep.
She managed this by counting sheep.
But now,
how strange!
Although she slept,
those massive jaws of hers kept chewing, chewing all through the night.
Even with nothing there to fight.
The sleeping woman's gripping trap,
opening and shutting, snap, snap, snap,
faster and faster, chop, chop, chop.
It just went on. The noise didn't stop.
Until at last her jaw inside.
To pause and open extra wide.
With someone's tremendous chew.
It bit the lady's tongue in two.
That is why we'll try so hard.
To save Miss Violet Beauregard from suffering an equal fate.
She's still quite young. It's not too late.
Providing she survives the cure.
We can't be sure.
We hope she does. We can't be sure.
Let's stop here a moment and catch our breath. And peek, and take a peek through the glass panel of the store. But whatever you do, don't go in the net room. Or they'll if you go in the net room, you'll disturb the miniature squirrels. Look, Grandpa, look.
Miniature squirrels.
There must be hundreds of them around that pack of nuts over there.
These squirrels are specially trained for getting the nuts out of walnuts.
But why use squirrels? Why not use oompa-loompas?
Because only squirrels can get home walnuts out of walnut shells. And I insist on using whole walnuts in my factory. See how they first tap each nut before opening it? And if it's a bad nut, they don't bother to open it. They just throw it down the rubbish chute.
Hey, Daddy, I've decided I'm a miniature squirrel.
You'll be silly, sweetheart. You love it when there's a long one.
I don't care about that. I want one. All I have at home is two dogs, four cats, six rabbits, three canaries, two birds, a turtle, a cage, a bowl full of fish, and a cage of mice, and a silly old hamster. I want one.
Very well, Wonka. How much do you want for these crazy little birds?
They're not for sale. She can't have one.
Who said that?
Someone will catch them like this.
bottom, I suppose.
What about the great fire incinerator?
Oh, that.
They only light it once or every other day.
I suppose today is the day that they let it burn out.
Children are disappearing like rabbits. Try one now. Terrific. But Mr. Wolf has
something like this, he'll get squashed.
Well, Mike, what'd you say?
No, you're not going to be able to watch any more TV. Right when we get home, hopped on that television set, right out the window. Well, Mike, I don't care what you jump and scream.
There.
Gee, how will Mike grow again?
Well, I guess we could stretch him out with one of my machines that I use for testing the elasticness of gum.
How far do you think he'll stretch?
Maybe miles. But he'll be awful thin. But we'll fatten him up with some of my candy vitamins. They contain every vitamin from A to Z. Hand these orders to the Oompa Loompas over there, and don't look so worried. They all come out in the box, you know, every one of them.
The most important thing we've learned so far is still in our concern is never, never, never let
Bimbo near, Kelly said.
Fall and flop and lounge about and stare at me. And stare until their eyes pop out.
Oh yes, we know it keeps them still.
They don't come out the windowsill.
They don't fight, kick, or punch.
They leave you free to cook the lunch and wash the dishes in the sink.
But did you ever stop to think?
To wonder exactly why.
They lost your senses in the head. It kills your imagination dead.
P.S. Guardian White Sport.
We very much regret that we
shall have to send it away to see.
We can get it back in height.
But if we can't,
it serves him right!
Hurry up!
I guess there's only Charlie left now, Mr. Anka.
You mean you're the only one left?
Why?
Yeah. Oh, my dear boy, that means you won.
Oh, I do congratulate you. I really did a great job. Well done.
You know, I had a hard time beginning with him and you.
We mustn't dally.
We have an enormous number of things to do before the day is out. Just think of the arrangements we have to make.
Wait, Mr. Anka. I'm afraid I don't understand all this. What are you talking about?
This whole day has been a contest to see who would be lucky to win and take a job.
What job?
Oh, do forgive me. I get carried away sometimes. I forgot to hit you in the head.
No.
Well, you see, Charlie, I'm tired. It's not getting any easier to carry out my ideas as it once was. So I need your help. That means you.
Me?
Yes. You see, I'd like you, Grandpa Joe, and of course the rest of your family to move here. Permanently move here. I need you people to take the job off when I'm gone. Will you accept the offer?
Will I?
Wow, this is more than I can ever.
Welcome to a show. Mom, Dad, and Ben Brooks. It's going to be all talk and fashion, and we're never going to stop again. Oh, just wait and see.
because we want to be a good audience. This afternoon we have the Oregon Tuba Ensemble. And if you look very carefully, you might recognize some of the people that are playing this afternoon. And I need to introduce one favorite person of mine, their director, Jeff Turay.
Thank you. Thank you.